I have a couple of additions to the program. I would like to thank Mike Sharp and Jared Baker for helping with the lights, and Angie Burleson for makeup, Jenny Sims and Chris Gower for programs and tickets. Sit back and enjoy the show. There will be a 10-minute intermission between Act 1. There will be no intermission between Act 2 and 3.
Yeah. Hey, come here. Listen to this.
Hey, Ed, why don't you play something for us?
Well, think of the going down the list with tomorrow. Do a little bit of snake hunting.
God is the state. The state is God.
What's that?
God's the state is God.
Well, who says that?
Paul. Trust me.
Oh, okay. I thought you said it.
Not the dream, you know. Cure me.
What difference does it make?
No.
What can you remember, Lester?
I go down to Macy's and I buy something, and there it is. I see it. But what's the government giving me?
Well, it gives you everything. It protects you.
What?
Quarters coming in and taking everything you got.
I don't think they're going to do that.
How do you like the occupation? How do you think we keep up the army, the navy, all those battleships?
Battleships? We haven't used battleships since the Spanish-American War. And what did that get us?
Cuba.
And we gave it back to them. No, Mr. Wilbur, I wouldn't mind paying, but to do something sensible.
Sensible? What about the Congress, the Supreme Court, the President of the United States? We've got to pay them,
don't we? Not with my money, though.
Look, I'm not here to argue. All I know is you owe 24 years back taxes, and you've got to pay them.
They've got to show me.
We don't have to show you. I just told you. What about interstate commerce and the Constitution?
All that Constitution was paid for long ago. Interstate commerce. What is interstate commerce?
Okay, there are 48 states, see, and you can't go from state to state without interstate commerce.
Why not? They got fences.
No, they haven't got fences. They've got law. God, I never came across this before in my life.
Well, I might pay about $75, but that's all it's worth for me.
You'll pay just like everybody else. You'll go to jail. Listen to this, Izzy. Let me tell you another thing. You'll go to jail. You hear me? You think you're better than everybody else? You've got another thing to do. That's all I have to say.
Hey, look out for those snakes down there. Keep up.
Step in, huh?
That must be Mr. Clinko.
Is it open?
Not if you don't want to.
I don't.
Would you like something to drink?
Everyone.
Excuse me, I saw you. You want to come along?
You know I follow you to the ends of the earth.
Just the kitchen's far enough.
Why, you've done it very simply, haven't you?
Yes, we've been deciding to do an empire and immigration.
So you settled for frigid air?
Yes, it's so easy to live with. Look, you're not happy, Mr. Perkins. A nice box full of cornflakes gives you a rough idea of the state tomorrow.
Of course. Why did they make these stupid problems? They're all over my coat.
I'll take mine in glass, if you don't mind.
There you are, Mrs. Curry. A foaming beer.
Anyhow, it's cold.
Now, Miss Sycamore, if you'll please be seated, I'd like to offer a toast.
We are seated.
Miss Sycamore, to you.
Thank you, Mr. Perkins.
You know something? I will not trade one moment of this evening for all the rights in China.
Really?
Cross my heart.
Is there much rights in China?
Terrific! Didn't you read The Good Earth?
Thank you.
families have got their curious little traits. My father raises orchids at $10,000 a bulb. Is that sensible? My mother believes in spiritualism. That can't be any worse than your mother running the place, can it?
It goes deeper, Tony. Your mother believes in spiritualism because it's a fashionable thing to do, and your father raises orchids because he can afford to. My mother rides clay because 8 years ago, a typewriter was littered by mistake.
Darling, what's all this?
It's lucky, Grandpa. 35 years ago, he just quit business one day. He started up to his office in the elevator, and he came right back down. He just quit. He could have been a rich man, but he said it took too much time. So now all he does is collect snakes and go to circuses and be mentored. It just never occurred to any of them.
Hello there, children.
Hello, Mr. Benton.
How's the weather out there? Looks like a nice summer evening.
It's lovely.
Yeah, oh, I'm off. I've got a date on the corner.
With who?
Oh, with a policeman. Yeah, we've got a standing date. 12:30 every night. He's really a lawyer. After he graduated, he came to me and said, I don't want to be a lawyer. I want to be a policeman. So I said, you just go ahead and be a policeman. What do you do? How do you like the new hat?
Very nice, Mr. Renrock.
Thanks. The governor gave it to me.
Mr. Benton, I made.
Now let the lunch.
You probably ought to just let her sleep it off.
Hurry, Bob, Miss London just passed out.
Yeah!
Yeah, but I wouldn't cast her in any religious way.
No, I don't smell
Hey, do me a favor. Next time you meet an actress on top of a bus, why don't you send her the script instead of paper? Thank you.
Is it very noticeable? I still got a little light here, though. My goodness, here the duck, the day I came to deliver ice, I was going to stay here for 8 years.
Well, you know, this is your surprise instead of you.
Okay. Why did he leave me now?
I don't know. He didn't leave. He died.
I used to be one of those people. Used to go down to that office 9 o'clock every morning.
struggle and fight. Then it occurred to me one day. Then it occurred to me that one day I wasn't having any fun.
So you did what?
Just quit. That was 35 years ago today. I've been a happy man ever since.
Hello, Mr. Doc.
Oh, my eyes. I have not seen you two. The president of my congratulations. May you live long. May you have many children. That is my passion.
That's what I thought.
Love is the only thing that's left to do, Grandpa.
Yeah, there's plenty of that.
Yeah, the sweet study will take that away too.
See, it's so nice to get into my art. Thanks again. Hi, Grandpa.
Hey, yes, indeed, Kim.
You are the brother of a Paris magazine.
I didn't know you was working for the WPA.
Oh, no, Donald.
You see, I used to be all the time.
It happened to me. I'm taking out my candy.
Follow every place on me.
Oh, Ed, you're just imagining things.
No, I'm not. Every time I take out my candy, he's following me.
Maybe he wants a piece of candy, Ed.
Yeah. It's all right for him. I'm going to be followed. You should have been in Russia. Then you would have been followed. In Russia, everybody was followed. I was told to cut out of Russia.
You see, Ed, it's just your imagination.
No, oh, maybe.
Oh, here we go!
Thank you.
careless of you. Very.
Now we all get mixed up.
Yes. Hey, Penny, why don't you get these folks some dinner? They did come for dinner, you know.
Oh, yes. We're really not very hungry at all. Why? It'll be no trouble at all.
Like that instead of breaking more.
Yes, I wouldn't be surprised.
that is a rather expensive hobby, Mr. Kirby, raising organs.
Yes, it is. But I feel that if a hobby gives one sufficient pleasure, it's never expensive.
That's very true.
See, I need something to relieve the daily nerve strain. After a week in Wall Street, I'd go crazy if I had something like that. A lot of men I know have yachts, just for that very reason.
Well, why don't they just give up Wall Street?
How's that?
Oh, I was just kidding.
I think it's important for everyone to have a hobby. It's much more to me than just a hobby. But my great solace is spiritualism.
Thank you.
what happens now?
This is the best part. Now I read your actions. Why don't we start with Mr. Kirby? Okay, here we go. Now everyone, this is Mr. Kirby. Potatoes, steak.
Oh, that is so good.
You can see how they go together? Steak and potatoes.
I just happen to think of it.
All right, the next word is bathroom. And Mr. Kirby's response?
It's toothpaste. Oh, for me.
Okay, the next word is lust. Unlawful.
Yeah.
Okay. The next word is honeymoon. Trip. Okay. And the last word is sex. Male.
That you are.
It is, isn't it? Yeah.
I've never heard of such nonsense.
stay here. Let me get my card. I left it.
Shut up, you. You're right, Steve. You end up still wearing it under your whole city.
Yeah, but we'll be sent to the fireboard.
Everybody in this house is under arrest.
Thank you.
I'll accept my 23 years back in the past. I get another letter every day.
What are you going to do now?
Well, I got a plan, but I don't know if it's going to work. I'm going to try it anyway.
Good evening,
everybody.
Come
on in, Clinkoff.
You'll forgive me. The door was open. Excuse my coming today. I knew you guys were all very upset.
Thank you.
Don't do it, Ed.
Ed, please.
Compromise right now, Ed. Do you know you have the stubbornest daughter in all of the 48 states?
That must be half.
Well, if it is, it certainly is our service.
Is Tony here, Alice?
Yes, he is, Mr. Curry. Please come in.
How do you do? Good evening. Tony, I want you to come home with me. Your mother is very upset.
Very well, Mom. Goodbye, Alice.
Goodbye,
I need hardly say that this is as painful to Mrs. Kirby and myself as it is to you people. I'm sorry, but I'm sure you understand.
Well, yes.
But in a way, no. Now, Mr. Kirby, I think me and you, we're much smarter than these two kids.
Grandpa!
Alice. Talking, Mr. Kirby. A cat can look at King Candy.
Would you like to come to that, Alice?
Go
ahead.
You've got a long time for the train, please.
Can you send a cat to 761 Claremont right away, please? That's right. Thank you.
Come on, Alice. Are you ready, Toby? Now, Mr. Kirby, I'm sure that after last night you think this family is, well, kind of crazy. No, I wouldn't say that. Although I'm not accustomed to going out to dinner and spending the night in jail.
Well, you have to remember, you did come on the wrong night. You should have come tonight. I bet nothing would have happened at all. Maybe.
Mr. Vanderbilt, it was not merely last night that convinced Mrs. Kirby and myself this engagement would be unwise. Thank you, Father, but I can handle my own affairs. For the last time, will you marry me?
Well, your father's right.
No, he's not. No, Alice, no. I think that you're not marrying this boy because we're the kind of people that we are.
I didn't say that, Grandpa.
No, that may be right, but just because we're the kind of people we are, no, that doesn't mean that we're right and they're right and you're wrong.
Grandpa, I didn't say that. I feel.
Now, what I feel is that 20 years, too nice of a boy to wake up 20 years from now with nothing in his wallet but socks and bottles. What's that?
Yeah.
Stuff and unhappy. The way you are, Mr. Kirby. I'm a very happy man, aren't you? Certainly I am.
Mr. Kirby, what do you think you get your indigestion from?
Happiness?
No, you get your indigestion because most of your time is spent doing things you don't want to do.
I don't do anything I don't want to do.
Oh, sure. You said just last night that after a week in Wall Street, you're pretty near crazy. Well, why don't you just give it up?
Why? Because that's my business. A man can't give up his business.
I'm sure you can. You've got all the money that you need. You can't take it with you.
What do you expect me to do? Live the way you do? Do nothing?
Well, I have a lot of fun. Time enough to do everything. Talk. Sing. Play the piano every once in a while. Just kind of sit back and watch the spring come along. Don't do anything I don't want to do. Don't have 6 hours of things I have to do before I get 1 hour of things I want to do. You know what else, Mr. Kirby? I haven't taken bicarbonate of soda in 35 years. Now, what's the matter with that?
The matter with this? Suppose we all did. A fine world we have. Everyone going to sue. The work.
Well, you're always going to have some people that like work. I mean, you can't stop the inventions and they fly the ocean.
No, and there's always going to be people that like to go down to Wall Street, too, because they enjoy it.
From what I've seen of you, Mr. Kirby, I don't think you're one of them. I think you're missing something.
I am not aware of missing anything.
Well, neither was I. So I quit. I used to be up at 9 o'clock sharp every morning. Be down at that office. I used to worry about everything. Get the account. I even used to worry about the world, too. I used to get all worked up about whether Cleveland or Blaine would be elected president. Seemed awful important at the time. Now, who cares? See?
Yes, I do see. It's a very dangerous philosophy, Mr. Grandpa. It's un-American. And it's exactly why I'm opposed to this marriage. I don't want Tony.
What's the matter with it, Father?
The matter with it? Why, it's downright communism, that's what it is.
You didn't always think so. didn't always think so, because there was a time when you wanted to be a trapeze artist. I came across those letters you wrote to my father. Do you remember those?
No! How dare you read those letters? How dare you?
Fireworks blew up,
That was Mr. Pinson's fault, not yours. Well, we just asked that we kind of go along in our own sort of way. You know, we kind of like to have a head. As far as everything else is concerned, we'll leave it up to you. Thank you.
Thank you. could put on that.
Thank you.
shone the moon that night, though the frost was cruel.
When a poor man came inside, gathering winter fuel. Ding dong, where's his wash with down? The Christmas bells are speeding. Ding dong, slowly rock.
On December 5 and 20, on
December 5 and 20. Boom, boom, boom. Now we all have voices raised and sing a song of grateful praise. Celebrate in song and story all the wonders of His glory. Boom, we all our voices raise and sing a song of grateful praise. Celebrate in song and story all the wonders of His glory. Boom, boom, boom,
boom. We're going to do another one back to back and then we'll show you what we
on December 5th. all the wonders of his glory. Boom, boom.
Technically for us, that was the best one. It takes us a couple to get used to the song and how long it is and where to go.